So, first start fire, then add items. There we go. Howdy folks, and welcome back to ARK Scorched Earth, the modded adventure series, with me, Scryptar, and our token pixie Jabba thing, right? As you can see behind me, stuff is happening. Let's have a look around here. I finally managed to finish all of this. I put in the gate, I even put in the door, I put in the glass door. I think that looks quite neat. It had to be an adobe gate because it is an adobe wall section here. I think the glass looks good. Also, it's S plus, opens automatically. That is quite nice. Let's switch off the outline here for a second. Also, that is done. That's our garage. We even have an ARK Advance light in here. That is quite freakingly hell. You know, look at that. That's the brightness you expect in hell. That should be enough for the rest of the base. I made a couple of these and then I realized that I don't have any ceiling to stick them on, except in here, and I can't even get that closer to the rock face over there, because that's the last place where it will place, like 1 inch off to this side? Forget it. So, alright. We have our workforce in here, and you, for whatever reason. That's mainly the whole purpose, have these three in here. Maybe we get a poison one or something like that. Other than that... yeah, that's done. It's good. It's not much of an architecture. Would you please open? Thank you. We have some door frames portraying windows. You have seen that from 100 other YouTubers as well. I mean, that's how we do it. That looks good. Still don't like this crack here. It's only there. I mean, it's everywhere, but it's really visible here. That's, I guess, because of the shadow. So you should have this on this side, and you do. Interesting. Alright, same there. No windows to this side, this is where the base is, there's nothing to see. Automatic doors, it's so nice. And look at this, we can look outside! That's actually glass there, you can see it. Let me jump. See, that's all glass. Like, wow! Nope, glass. I love it, this is so awesome. It looks quite weird when you look at it from the side. Because then you can see the outside of these glass windows, and it's opaque from the outside. It's even glass up there. And some ceilings, yeah. Well, until they hit the rock face, and then I stopped. I think I need one more right there. That's gonna bug me otherwise. Need to reach that, though. I had to put up scaffolding and everything so I could walk up there, and then I had to actually walk up the roof to finish half of the stuff. I fell down like 6 times? Yeah. Died as many times, so yeah, that's good. I can't remember how often I tried to walk up here and then realized, glass, the door is here. I will do that more often. I moved this back one tile, you can walk up there. Oh, that's not good. One tile this direction, so it's not obstructing that gate. It's also quite nice. Any further that direction is nice because we have creatures standing up there. And this one is not gonna extend in that direction, so it doesn't need to be over there. Other than that, that's what it looks like. Also extended the walkway down here a little. And this is where my bathroom is gonna be. The only place so far that we will have that should get a house buff. Hopefully. We'll see. Not sure yet. That's it for this structure. I'm not quite sure how this is gonna work out. I will try a couple of things and then might do the final build with you guys together. If we are going to extend, we're going to extend from here. This is too wide. You come down there, you turn around here, you have to do that anyway, and I will switch these all to manual and leave them open, I believe, because they are quite annoying. It's nice that they open for you, but they open all the time. It's not Star Trek. Doors open only then when you actually want to go through there. They're not, you know, they can't read your minds. But we might go down here, like 2 or 3 ramps, and then branch out from there so that we stay under this nice natural bridge thing. Don't really see the need to walk down there. I mean, you don't walk all the way over here to come down there and then walk all the way back over there just to reach a platform that's like right here. So yeah. Also, if you want to die, jump off here. I was thinking about putting some more dope ceilings in here. It's just three more that we would need. I'm pretty sure I am going to do that so we can get rid of the railings here and just have this a nice big turning area for dinosaurs. We'll see. But for now. For now I need everything. So then up here I stuck two small wood pillar, S plus small wood pillars in here. One of these is exactly one wall high, so these are two walls high now. Extended outward until I could place a foundation. And yes, these actually do snap. Can I get my outline back? Maybe? Thank you. So you see, when I put this down here, this actually snaps. Or wherever it would place, really. So that's quite nice. Basically, I'm gonna remove this. I just wanted this to be exactly that height and parallel to the rest we built here. This is gonna be our barn area type thing. So what I've done is, once I placed that, I went out this way and I went out that way until I could go out no further. As you can see, nothing will connect here. Not even here. That's okay. Then I went out that way, and obviously I could go out a little further over here. I think I could manage three more before they vanished in the ground. Yeah. Hey, I do remember things. But then when you go this way, as you can see, this actually... The tunnel over there is slightly higher than this, so obviously if this already vanishes in the ground, then those over there will as well. I did not want that. This is supposed to be a foundation, not something hidden. So we had to break off here and then went over there, and that worked. We have a little area right here that looks a little wonky. That's these two. I can live with that. That's not too bad. It's an adobe structure. There's supposed to be some corners of the wall where sand might seep in and then settle down. That's okay, I can live with that. So this is a corner, and then obviously going back down here, we could go out further, no problem at all. I can go like up to right here if I wanted, but you see this problem, right? Obviously nothing would place here. I might cover that with ceilings and go out this way. I'm not quite sure yet. What is it I want to do? I want this to be our main barn, and I think it's gonna look like a barn. Hey, Dodie. Are you a Dodie worth taming? No, you're not. You're a vanilla Dodie. Even if you were a level 2000, you weren't worth taming. Alright, so this is going to be our barn. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go downstairs and see if the foundations have crafted up. This is a 12 by 8, I believe. Yep, so that's 96 foundations. I only have 11 more. And then I'm going to place these down. All of this support structure can now go away, naturally. Also, when you think that regular ARK is weird sometimes when it comes to placing and collision and all of that, Structures Plus isn't any better in terms of weirdness. Like, oop, where is it? Yeah, exactly, it's down here. So there is no ceiling here. This is last ceiling, because why would I place any more ceilings? This is already obstructed. But that foundation would now place in there. I actually make that viewable any... Nope. Nope. Not by any trick I can come up with in 2 seconds. I might prepare that and after a cutscene I might show you, but nah, not at the moment. It's good. So this is gonna be our barn, and since this is exactly two walls higher than that, and since we know that a ramp is a 45 degree angle, we need two ramps to connect this to that. That's good, so we go out like one ceiling, or we might be able to put another foundation here. Looks weird. One with the ramps, you might not really see that. Can we do one more over here? Oh yes, we can. So we might have a little balcony type deal, little front porch, then just go down there. That's cool. That also enabled us to have a ramp here, and then maybe a ramp here, so we can go down that side and that side of the barn if we have to. Nice. So, let's get to it. And it's all done. Nah, just kidding. That would be too easy, right? Well, we got two front doors. That's nice. I like how this is overlapping here. This looks really good. That was a good job. Definitely was. So I switched them to manual and I leave them at that, I'm pretty sure. Maybe auto-closing, but definitely not auto-opening, because you will be running in and out of this for a while. And it's supposed to keep our creatures safe inside, right? So, we'll have to see what we can actually put in here. It's not that big, it looks fairly big, and it's huge when it comes to height. I could use gates like half the height. This is, what, 6 walls high? That would be enough. Like, to where that horizontal beam is there? Fine, 7 walls high. Okay, I take that. Don't really need the full, what is it, 12? 14? Something like that. Anyway, we will need more clay, so I have to go and make a chemistry bench to get this going. I don't know if there's any faster way. I guess I'll ask around and see if there's something in the mods that will give you something like chemistry table, just better. We'll see. I guess the S+ one will already be pretty cool. Other than that, we have this landing area on the side. I had to rework this like 2-3 times, you saw that. Still missing a pillar here, which is just for decorative purposes, but I thought, well, might as well. Might as well make it look good. I had this one white in the beginning, and it was a good idea, and then I remembered we need to get these dinosaurs down there at some stage. So it needs to be two white like the rest of all of this. Makes sense, right? Also, there is this weird edge here. See, I can't walk up there. So if I'm coming from here and I walk up here, it's fine. But if I drop down here and I don't have anything to get up here, then I need to go all the way back and around. And that's, you know how fast that gets annoying, right? So I'm not going to do that. I guess I put the standard gate in here, like 4 high. Should be good. Probably going to extend these door frame window things one higher. We'll need to see what that looks like. If they are too long, they just look bad, I think. And then we have to see what we can fit in here. Let's see. Technically everything that's hopping around here. Ooh, yeah, I forgot that. You were pretty fast. And I press shift. Stupid. Just... No. Just tap W slightly. Oh, don't get stuck on the rock. Don't shoot off in the distance. That works. I'm just gonna leave you right here. This box will be perfect for that guy. Once you're in there, stuck. And of course, Queen of the Sky. Also, I don't know if you could follow the chat there, but we have now activated the whole Dragon Godlings things. And yeah, it's getting dangerous now. Not that it wasn't dangerous before, but now we're gonna have fun. I think that also means if we have Dragon Godlings, we should have this whole Midas Touch thing, right? So we should be able to upgrade our things. I like that. I've never played around with that. I've only played around with the upgrade potion that you could make in resource crops, which I quite liked. So we'll have to see how that goes. Yeah, I got all the creatures down. How's our status? This takes ages. Better, we're already out of things. What's missing? Sand. Oh, that's okay. Yeah, I need 2-to-1 ratio, so we have more of this. Sand. Sand is okay. We have 600. Can we pull? Clay. Ooh, yeah. It's not too bad. It can just about keep up with what we're doing. Just about isn't good enough. Go in there. All of us happy. Alright. So that's enough building for now. I will probably put up most of the walls by myself. I think a building montage of this, you know, me just walking around putting up walls, one higher, one higher, one higher. It's not really that interesting, I believe. There will be sort of a custom-made roof on this. I think this will not just be a box. I wanted to have it a barn shape, you know? With those gates, well, if we had put them on that end and on that end, it would have worked. But if we put a gate on this end, where are you going to put the dinosaurs? We have to have room to walk around. No, especially for Speedy. So that was the most logical thing, I think. I'm also not sure if I keep this extension over here. Or if we make something different, if we actually lift this up like 4 or 5 levels. Flush with the top of the window doorframe things. Then have that as flyer storage and have some pillars to make it look supported. I don't know. We'll see. This will grow dynamically and I will remodel this probably quite heavily as soon as we start getting in some more creatures. This Alpha RG isn't the biggest thing we want to get put in here. And Buzzer is quite big. I mean, you can see from tail to head it fits in here and we still can walk around. That's fine. But we also do need to be range of the feeding trough and all of that. And that is a bit of an issue right now. Are you in range? Yes, you are. Can I get off here? Hello. Don't make it too easy on me. There you go. I guess for the moment. It's not really a need to park them in here, right? I mean, you walk just right out. We don't even care. But since there's no roof on it and everything can get to it, except for maybe scorpions, there's no real need to keep them in here. I mean, they can deal with scorpions. you have feeding trough? Yeah, you do have a feeding trough somewhere. Good. Wish me luck. Yes, perfect. Right, let's bring the creatures back down, and then I guess we'll do something else, and maybe even hunt ourselves a dragon godling or something. Before we do anything else, I have one more workstation I want to put down. That is this one. Oh, that one fast. How big are you? Oh, that's cute. Now, where do we put you? Oh, you know what? I just put you over here for now to the rest of the weird things. That is the... It's not a campfire. It's a blueprint crafter. First start fire, then add items to create blueprints. Items get destroyed. Heavy items take more time. Alright, so... Let's try that. Oh, seems like we got a drop somewhere. Is that ours? Yeah, that's ours. If it illuminates the base like this, it's our drop on top. Our drop on top. Nice. Let's have a look. What could we... Pretty sure there's something in here that we could blueprinterize. We have crap stuff. No, let's take that one and see if that works. And we do need a little bit of firewood. That much. Looks weird. So, first start fire, then add items. There we go. Stop it. 770 and 700. Oh, wow. It's only 10,000 polymer, 10,000 metal, and 9,000 cementing paste. I can do that in one afternoon, right? Oh, wow. Okay, I like that. Good I didn't take that one. Well, if it destroys them, I think that's fair. Can you do... Not in here. Can you do... Simple stuff. Let's say... It's an S plus Adobe Foundation. See if you can do, like, cross-mod things. Should! Command... No. Command line-wise, it's like changing a 1 into a 0 or the other way around, so... Shouldn't be that difficult. Yeah, S plus Adobe Foundation. Cool. Don't need that. Just wanted to test it. Very nice. Thank you. I like that. So whenever we find a decent trank gun, we might just stick that in there. And we might probably just take every bow we can find. Anything that's worse than the one we have. Currently we only have one other. Just throw that in there and see if we get a better blueprint. What the heck is that? Wildmail Apex Rex. I think they were added just today in the most recent patch. They supposed to have a special ability? Like a special attack? I have no clue. I have no clue how good or bad they are. And as you can see from my lovely XP pad, we don't really have the option of attacking that right now. Also, stuff. Well, that's K-mode. Not good. Not coming after me. No, you're not coming after me. Good. You went away and vanished. Perfect. There's so much stuff around here. I would love to tame that. I have no idea if that's a thing. Otherwise, I'd love to kill that. I have no idea if that's a thing. Definitely not in this guy. The dragon godlings are spawning in. What are you? Why is that a thing? A better angle on you. You're a frog. White female Meteorog the frog. Ah, nice. Shout out to Meteorog right there. That's cool. pick you up. Guess that's a no? No, that's a you're too stupid. Do it right. Okay. Let's see, I think Bowden Space is just around the corner. You might have a taming pen there. Are you dangerous in any way? I don't really want to try. I guess they can be. I have no idea. Let's see. Oh, I'm doing quite a bit of damage here. Don't tell me you're already knocked out. Don't trust this. You're unconscious. You're way too unconscious. That seems to be working. Hello. Sting. Needs a saddle. Yeah, sure. I do have a frog now. For whatever reason. Interesting stats. Nothing. Alright, so it's just a normal frog that looks slightly better than expected. Alright, I can live with that. Where were we? Dragon Godlings. Yeah, they are spawning. Not that many, not that high a level, and I got to fight with the Dodo Rex here, that's why... Buzzer? Yeah, Buzzer is his name. That's why Buzzer isn't looking too good, so... I don't think we're gonna get into a fight with one today. I wanna read up on them and see what I can find out, so that we have some information before we do this. You know, always be a little prepared. Never really hurts. Unless you're Mortuary, then you can be prepared as much as you want, you still die. Alright, so, let me get that home. Is it just me or did he shrink? That is weird. Oh, this mod, man. I had that once before when I was on my wolf and we were out there shortly before we started taming these guys. All of a sudden, the wolf and I shrank, and we were the size of a Titan or Myrna or something, and everything else was a little bit too big. It looked weird. I just had to log out and log back in, and everything was fine, but I don't know. That's weird. Alright. There's a drop coming in, which we can't see because glare. I'm already gamma down. Let's gamma down even further. That helps a little bit. Alright. This is coming along nicely. Dragon Godlings, not so many in this area. Over there where the forge area is on vanilla, that's where I found most of them. But there's so many creatures around there, I wouldn't even begin to know how to tame one. Let's see, yes. Well, with this lovely picture... Oh, that happens way too often. With this lovely picture, that's it for today, folks. If you like the video, subscribe for more. Leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourselves. See you next time.